social media, it's so tricky because everything is filtered. So the only things that you see are the things that people want you to see.
Of course. Yeah.
You know,
course.
It's not accidental. It's not...
And
it's carefully curated. It's like a museum of your life.
Even when you talk about platforms like hers or mine, I'll be honest, like there are days when you also feel burdened to be smarter than you are, for example, right? So there's also that trap that that becomes a persona. You understand?
So you have like an online personality
like
now.
Talking about your issues also becomes a persona. So you have to be careful to stay real because like, for example, I've recently experienced this where somebody's like, oh, you know, this issue has happened. What are your views on it? And I'm like, but I'm not a social activist.
Yeah.
And they're like, what do you mean you're not a social activist? I said, but you see, what happens is, again, you're boxing me.
Yeah. And also the idea that being vocal and having thoughts and opinions on things, it doesn't necessarily make you an activist. It makes you somebody who is vocal and thinking. And we do have opinions on a lot
of
things.
And I'm not saying I understand the world.
Yes.
I am not saying I'm an expert on how the world should be. I'm only saying... this is how I'm feeling.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. And that's the only thing I can really communicate without needing like some expertise on anything. Mm. Like I'm like, okay, I'm sad.
Yeah, like this is my opinion. This is
how I feel. Yeah, paparazzi. I think people have this innate need to box you or label you. Mm. And, you know, a lot of times they will try to say, oh, you're a journalist. Yeah. Like, no, I'm not a journalist at all. Not pretending to be a journalist. I am a publisher. But they didn't really understand that. Even now, I feel like it is hard. Like you said, there is pressure. Even if you're trying to be as real and authentic as possible to encourage other people to do so, there's some days where I'm so busy with the kids that I can't post. And I do feel bad. I'm like, oh my God, it's been 4 days. I haven't posted anything. So I'll write something like, hi guys, I'm very busy. See you soon.
I haven't forgotten.